Yeah, give me the words and I got the flow. See, I don't gotta write, I got the Holy Ghost. Yeah, that's called a ghost writer. Jeremiah 5 and 14, that's so fire. Isaiah 14 and when I retire, out of captivity, I broke the iron. Who that is coming out of Mount Zion? Woolly head, looking like a lion.
1,000 men marching with no drums on, no trombone, just boots on. Use our voices screaming out, take care of your homes, take care of your wives, take care of your own.
Now we standing out here in the valley of the bones. This place called America, this is not your home. This is like a tomb, place where you died at. Now I resurrected, trying to bring the 12 tribes back.
I came on a slave ship and
I ain't even like that.
Put my neck in a rope and
I couldn't even fight back.
Sold on an auction block, took a man.
Thing they did to our Gadai brothers. Can I see the image that I was like staring right at? Same thing they did when they came over here the first time, making all kind of treaties with them, speaking in languages they don't know, and we just sitting there.
Oh, gosh. That was dumb.
Like, it looks like they got them up there for a prop.
We read something. It is a prop. Yeah. But you do see them fringes they got hanging out from them.
That's right.
Right.
Hey, let's scroll down. Let's read some of this article.
In a landmark statement made today, the Vatican formally repudiated a centuries-old theory of church decrees that endorsed the forceful seizing of native lands and near-total destruction of indigenous peoples. Mm-hmm. The decrees or papal bulls underpin the doctrine of discovery, a legal concept created in the 1823 U.S. Supreme Court decision that justified the forceful seizing of native land by European colonizers under the guise that colonizers discovered the land.
Wow, go ahead.
In a joint statement issued by the Vatican's Development and Education Departments, the Catholic Church repudiated those concepts that failed to recognize the inherent human rights of indigenous peoples, including what has become known as the legal and political doctrine of discovery. The doctrine of discovery is not a part of the teaching of the Catholic Church. According to the statement, which acknowledges the sufferings of indigenous people due to the expropriation of their lands, as well as the policies of forced assimilation promoted by the governmental authorities of the time intended to eliminate their indigenous cultures.
Forced assimilations. That's what they're about. Forced assimilation. They had policies for these things. If you can look to the right over there, scroll down a little bit over to the right, you see casting call for reservation dogs. They make, this is how you know that you have the power of war, you backed by Satan, that you can make movies of the genocide or TV shows of the genocide of a whole people and put it on network TV and make money off of it.
Come on now, dog.
Reservation dogs. You call them dogs. And name a show after them and got them in it because they ain't got no money in the first place.
Look at it.
Let's read that doctrine of discovery because a lot of people don't know about the doctrine of discovery. This is that white man coming up with a whole bunch of stuff, finding things of where people already were. Read that.
The doctrine of discovery is not a part of the teaching of the Catholic Church. According to the statement, which acknowledges the sufferings of indigenous people due to the expropriation of their lands, as well as the policies of forced assimilation promoted by the governmental authorities of the time intended to eliminate their indigenous cultures.
Now, don't be fooled by Esau. It says governmental authorities of the time intended to eliminate their indigenous cultures. That still applies today. How do we know? If you've done any research on Native Americans and they're not reservations. What do you call those concentration camps that they live on? You know that they have liquor stores set up right outside of the reservations to keep them drunk, so they will always forget their indigenous culture.
Right.
Come on now, dog.
See, that's why our people never really understand the true meaning of being racist. Because they don't understand, it's not just a word calling someone nigger or negro or whatever you may call it, it actually goes into having the ability or the power to oppress.
There you go.
To change history, to rewrite history.
Uh-huh.
Those all go into racism.
Hey, you know how they ended up rewriting history? They said, and then when you read the article, it says the colonizers discovered America. Here's the oxymoron of it all, and this is how they look like the heroes. If the if you have to discover something, that means there's nothing that was there.
Right.
But if you have to colonize something, that means there has to be people there.
Right. Good point.
So they changed definitions
real quick, and let's read that last paragraph they got on it.
The statement comes after decades of advocacy from indigenous communities for the church to formally retract the numerous papal bulls that backed the expansion of Christianity.
Of what?
That backed the expansion of Christianity
uh-huh.
at the cost of native land and lives.
Give me that scripture real quick in Deuteronomy 33 and 29. This comes after decades of them being destroyed as a people, turned into drunkards, forced to, if they want to be prosperous here in America, you have to come off of that concentration camp that we put you in, and you have to assimilate with our ways.
That sounds like a hate group.
Sound like a hate group. America is a hate group.
Damn.
They forced them to come out and assimilate and to be one with their society. They can't walk in their job with a traditional Native American garment on. They got fringes on, and they got the moccasins and everything on.
Right, right.
And do what they've always done and be okay with everybody around there. They don't do that. They dress up in suit and ties. Hell, even the casinos that they got the $5 Indians set up running, they are in suits.
Wait a minute.
They got on slacks. They got on dress shoes running those places. They ain't walking around looking like the Native Americans that we have seen of old in the cowboys and Indian movies. They're not dressed like that. Read that in Deuteronomy 33:29. I'm going to show you how they lie us. Read that.
Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 29. Happy art thou, O Israel, who was like unto thee, O people saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellency. And thine enemies shall be found liars unto thee.
That's what our brothers got to wake up to. That although the, John Paul, whatever, I don't give a damn what his name is. He's sitting up there saying that we don't agree with the papal bulls from the previous popes that were before me. They are repudiated to me, and we take those things back. Well, how about you give them the damn land back then?
That's right.
That's real justice. Yep. That's real what you call empathy.
Right.
Were you able to actually give them something of some substance to take back all the atrocities that you've done to them as a people?
That's right.
If not, then you ain't nothing but a liar. That's the words. And this is what we got to do as a people. For all of us that are Gadites, we have to stop believing in these false and empty words of Esau that come to no avail for us. Issue an apology, and then where are they going to go back to?
Reservation.
Go right back to the concentration camp.
Yeah. Right.
Okay. And on the drive home, they're going to be like, yeah, we met the Pope, and he said sorry for the 500 years of genocide that he's done to us.
Hey, Cap, and the crazy part about it is, if he's really sorry, again, like you said, just give back the land, right? And then reject his PayPal ship. Is that the correct word? His office ship or his pedophilia ship.
Yeah, whatever you call it.
Pedophilia ship.
If he rejects that whole title and then try to make a difference, then from there we know by your actions that you're sorry.
Yep, right. Yep. And here's the proof that God, the Bible's a true book. God says, your enemy shall be found liar. Who is an enemy other than the people that actually stripped you of the language that you were speaking, took your land, put you in, as Bishop Yawasop says, the bathroom, the toilet of your own country, and then built churches over your dead bones and said, God bless America and come find Jesus in this building.
That's
more of an enemy than a people that would do that. These people are so much your enemies that they even make movies about how they destroyed your race. They're going to make money off of how they destroyed you in a movie.
Look at it.
Play the clip, because I found these. I think somebody posted this, but they made a movie about destroying a race. They made a movie about genocide, y'all, and people put money into that, because you know it takes producers and executive producers to put money.
Right.
They read the script and was like, this is going to bring me a return back telling the story of the genocide of Native Indian people. Look at it. Played it.
Can't remember.
Yes, you.
I don't.
Oh, you're blocking up.
9 ingredients of salt.
Oil, lye, and water.
What kind of oil?
Any kind.
Well, I prefer your answers without the flippance. What is lye?
It's from ashes.
What is from ashes?
The alkaline.
Alkali? How do you get alkali? How?
I don't know.
Why don't you know? It was in yesterday's lecture.
I can't remember.
Yes, you!
I don't! Oh, you're blocking up! You will not speak that godless filth in my house!
That was some language. Damn, Gad, haul it off for me. Now, look at this. Okay, now, you can cut it right there. She's speaking her language, that godless
filth. That's right.
Now, you know the Native Indians spoke what? A form of Hebrew. Right. Broken Hebrew, because that's who they are. We're going to get that a little bit later, too. But she said that language is godless filth. You see her destroying them. And that was what? A boarding school.
Mm-hmm.
That's a boarding. Give me that in Deuteronomy 28. At verse 32.
Deuteronomy chapter 28 and verse 32.
So they have forcibly removed the children from off the concentration camps and the lands that they found them in. And did this to them. Go ahead.
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
That's it right there. This is history that that our ancestors of the Native American brothers, their children were taken from them and given to another people. And they put it in a movie and show you how they gave them to another people and beat them for not knowing how to make soap. Cat. That's what she made a beater for. And oil, lye, and alkali or something.
And then one thing, too, remember that movie that we was watching yesterday? What they displayed is that spirit of fear. So I'm just trying to bring that back up to you, because remember what you said, right, about when we was watching what movie was we watching yesterday?
Lucy.
And then all of a sudden, Lucy pointed a gun at somebody mm-hmm. and says, do you speak English?
Shot him. He said, no, shot him.
There you go. Mm. So they're trying to indoctrinate a lot of us by using that spirit of fear, knowing with that spirit of fear, we process things a little bit faster.
Yeah.
So that way we could understand that you're no longer Israel, but you're whatever they call you.
Now, check this out. Go play the second clip to that movie. Now, remember, we just read the scripture says, thy enemies shall be found liars. Let's see how true that is. Play that clip.
I wonder what precipitated her attack on you, Sister Mai.
Oh, I'm sure I've no idea, Father. A wild animal, this one.
Show me your hands, child. What was the question you couldn't answer?
She was asking me about soap instead of alkaline instead of alkali.
Sister Mai, step forward, please. Would you place your hands on the desk, please?
Now look at this. You would think that this... Now look,
would you recite 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1, please?
If I speak in the tongues of men...
Continue.
That Native American sister's getting justice from
the
white man.
Angels.
They are not all bad. Look at them.
But have not
love. Some of them was on our side.
The verse, sister...
I'm a noisy gong or a cymbal, clanging cymbal, and if I have prophetic powers and understand all knowledge...
Faster, sister.
stronger than if I hop on faith.
Faster!
Still has to remove mountains, but hop on long.
Faster!
Now you see, stop right there. You see that the Gadite sister told the white man to stop. Play the next one.
How dare they declare God's statutes?
He now look at that. He stood up for the Gadite woman. That so according to what we just saw, I'll see all of them ain't bad. They're not liars.
So
some of them helped us.
Check.
Can you play the next clip?
Now look at that, Sister Marie. You beat the child and yet she begs for mercy on your behalf. I have compassion for you, my child.
Listen.
I understand your desire.
Listen.
To lash out at a sister who lacks compassion, but you lash out. Place your hands on the shelves, please. I have compassion, but I have no mercy.
Pause it.
Woo!
That's Christianity.
That's it.
Yep.
Read that scripture again, Deuteronomy 33:29. Pull it back up, y'all. Come on, man. I pause it for a reason. Come on. Who's the director over there? Read that scripture. He says, I have compassion. He beat that white woman.
Sleep, Cap. He's
it looked like he was on our side. What the hell's going on? Oh, God. Bless your heart. There we go. It looked like he's on our side.
Mm-hmm.
Keep rewinding a little bit more. Just so I can see it. I have compassion. Fast forward it.
But I have no mercy.
Pause it. I have no mercy. Read it.
Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 29. Happy art thou, O Israel, who is like unto thee, O people saved by the Lord, the shield of thy help, and who is the sword of thy excellency. And thine enemies shall be found liars unto thee.
Liars. They have never been for our benefit. So the Pope coming and telling the Native Americans 600 years after genocide, oh, the stuff that the former popes did with the papal bulls and conquering y'all land and assimilating y'all, we don't agree with that. Man, they don't mean shit.
The hell is
Cap,
this?
You know what's crazy about the whole thing? It shows you how Christianity was formed.
Yeah.
When it first got implemented, formed, it said, let's go conquered. Mm-hmm. They conquered with Christianity, bloodshed everywhere.
Yep, exactly right.
Hey, and Cap, you know how that goes? That goes right back to scripture, if I can get one. Ezekiel 35. And read verse 5.
We got another clip we're going to play after this script, too, because remember, that white man looked like the good guy.
This is how we know we talk about the right person when it comes to Esau's character. When he said, I have no mercy, read that.
Ezekiel chapter 35 and verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred.
No mercy.
And hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity. In the time that their iniquity had an end.
That's that perpetual hatred. That's what you're saying. Yep. No mercy.
I have compassion, but I have no mercy.
That's a cold precept.
Spread that girl's legs, kicked her feet from out from under her, and proceeded to beat her.
Come on now, dog.
The last part of this video. I don't know what it's called. If y'all know what it's called, man, put it in the comments.
Oh, the movie.
Let us know. I just saw it on TikTok. They got it broken up. But it speaks to the lying that this man does. We repudiate those. We don't agree with them. You agree with them? That's the only way that Rome or was able, after the time of the conquest of America, was able to stay a power in the earth is by taking the resources from here, colonizing the people here, stealing the gold from here, and trading slaves. Play that last part for him.
American women must maintain the house. Line yourselves against the wall facing me. When I say, you will sweep to the edge in my direction. Now sweep.
That's what it's called, 1923. Slap.
Did I say sweep it off the edge? Now you have a mess on the steps.
She's a warrior, revolutionary. I dare you do something to me. Now look at this. Look who comes to save that white woman.
We ask you to bless this food.
Look at the food, y'all.
That it may nourish us and sustain us. Be the door that quit Jewish.
She whooped her ass again. Beat her ass again. Shout out to Gang for the warrior spirit.
That's right.
By looking to save that white woman.
Perhaps the hot books will teach you the piety Sister Mary failed to impart upon you. If you speak that filth in my school again.
What did, pause it. What did, go back so we can see the words. Just, what did he call it language again that they were speaking?
Filth.
He called it, she called it godless filth. He called it filth. This is the man that pretended like he was on our side, on the Gadite side, and then proceeded to beat her. And this is the same thing that they done to get us to learn their language. They called it filth. Godless filth, whatever we spoke it. And they beat it out of us.
That's that smooth. It says his mouth smooth with butter, but yeah, war was in his heart. Yeah, that's what that is right there.
Go ahead, Officer.
Remember this is the hypocrisy. Remember how they were quoting 1 Corinthians 13, right, about the cherry thing?
Good point.
Isn't that the same chapter that I talk about the tongues?
Good point.
What happened to that? Why did they cancel the different language?
Anything but that language that would connect you to who you are as a people. You might realize that, damn, what's this language y'all speak? Somebody you read in the book said, hey, the language that they say we speak is called Hebrew. But only Hebrews I read about a lot of times is in the Bible. They call Israelites. Then the mind would auto-correct itself, and you would start to think outside of what they have told you, calling you American and blacks and Haitians, Jamaican, Puerto Ricans, and wetbacks, and what do they call Native Indians? Redskins. You would start to think outside of it, because your language would tie you back somehow,
some way. That's right.
They beat it out of you, though. Go back and play that, though. Watch this.
If you speak that filth in my school again, I will bury you alive. Mm. And the world would be done with you.
Cut it. I will bury you alive.
Christianity.
Jeremiah 50:33. This is for all the Negroes that be out there say, hey, nah, them ain't our people. Them ain't us. Well, damn, you put her in a hot box. I could have swore I saw in another movie called Django where they put the Django's wife in a hot box.
Yep. Wow. Well, why will the same people treat the other race different?
Right.
They treated all of us the same way.
Yep.
Right. That's right.
Read that scripture, Jeremiah 50:33.
Jeremiah chapter 50 and verse 33.
Freedom.
Thus saith the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah.
The children of Israel would be our Native American brothers. They are referred to the children
That's
of Israel
right.
in the Bible. The Hispanics and the Native Americans will be the children of Israel. And the children of Judah would be the so-called blacks in the Bible.
That's right.
And what was it about us that God said? Keep reading.
We're oppressed together.
We were oppressed together. They did to us the same thing they did to you.
That's a cold
They took our
preset.
Language. They took your language. They took your dress code. They took our dress code. They put you in a hot box. They put us in a hot box. They took us, and this is the thing too. They took us from our parents and sold us to British Americans. Right. They took y'all and sold y'all.
Right.
Right.
You know what the crazy thing about it that I'm seeing is that they call Hebrew a filthy language. Mm-hmm. But when you look at the Bible, what was it translated from? From Hebrew, Aramaic, and then the Greek. So are they saying that the Bible is filth?
Oh,
they
yeah.
don't really believe in the Bible.
No, they don't believe in it.
Of course not.
Not at all. Not at all. At all, man.
They just use the Bible when only if it benefits them.
Give me the image of the thought that they have until this very day. It ain't changed, man. Go ahead. Read that.
This resource includes the full text from Captain Richard Henry Pratt's speech, in which he used the now well-known phrase to describe his philosophy of assimilation. Kill the Indian in him and save the man.
And do what?
And save the man.
Kill the Indian in him and save the man.
What in the hell?
The speech was delivered in 1892 during the National Conference of Charities and Correction, held in Denver.
Okay, now go to that other article, because they still think that same way. You kill the Indian in them, make them assimilate, make them be American. That's why they refer to them as Native Americans. They have never changed on the census of what they called themselves before the white man came here and lied to them. Now, see, this is why God is going to judge the white man. I want y'all to pay attention to this. It would be different if they came and declared war. You know, when you declare war on somebody and you beat them in war, then it's a certain level of, okay, y'all lost. Mm-hmm. Y'all tried to fight, y'all lost.
Right. No.
The white man didn't do that to the people of this land. He came here, as you said, Daniel, and spoke what? Smooth words. He signed treaties. He said that we here to learn your ways. Can you teach us how to plant corn and survive? Can you teach us how to use soap on our ass? They did not say that we are coming to take over this land, and if you want to fight to keep it, well, then declare war. They did not say that. They came with smiling faces, but a sword was in their hand.
Right.
That's the difference in why everybody says you stole America. That's what you never hear when they say, they talk about Indians. Like, no, they conquered them in war. You never hear that being said.
Nope.
You always hear it say they stole America.
That's right.
Because they came smiling, but sword. Get the scripture, man. We're going to say what God said.
Bring it out.
Hey, Cap, you know, yeah. I just looked him up, right, because I wanted to read a little bit about him, right?
Uh-huh.
Something interesting about the kill the Indians, save the men,
mm-hmm.
they referred that to the Indians going to their boarding school, like to yeah. kill the
what
Indian,
what we just
right?
saw.
Watch this. What does DeSantis have in Florida? Don't teach nothing wow. about woke or black history. Same thing.
Kill the nigga, save the man.
Yep.
Damn, thou art a prophet.
Cold blooded right there.
The same thing that happened to our brothers, Gad. The same thing that happened to us. You black folk gonna have to start realizing we the same people. Hell, more than that, our Native American brothers gonna have to realize we the same people.
Yeah.
We the Israelites. It's time for us to come together and gather together, O nation not desired. Hell, you ain't desired. We wasn't desired. We still ain't desired. You still ain't desired. Psalms 55 and read verse 20 and 21. This is why they always say they stole America. You never hear the word saying they conquered America. They call themselves conquistadors, but you never hear in the annals of history, yeah, they conquered their war, who they had a war against. It's always they stole America as the consensus from everybody when you talk about that history.
Read that.
Psalms chapter 55 and verse 20.
Bring it out.
He hath put forth his hands against such as be at peace with him. He hath broken his covenant. The words of his mouth were smoother than butter.
We come in peace. Teach us how to farm. We just want to explore the land. What's going on? We want to trade with you. Keep reading.
But war was in his heart.
Uh-huh.
His words were softer than oil. Yet were they drawn swords.
That's why everybody that speaks about the history of the Native Americans and the Spaniards and the British always say they stole America. It's never that they was conquered in war. They stole it because they spoke smooth words, but war was in his heart.
That's a
he didn't even tell concept. Them that they was coming for war. They didn't have a chance to prepare. Go to that other article about Oklahoma. Read that for him.
This is the Gaylord College of Journalism and Mass Communications, the University of Oklahoma. Kill the Indian, save the man. Remembering the stories of Indian boarding schools.
Mm-hmm. Let's read that real quick.
Six rows of white tombstones, each belonging to a child who died while attending the Carlisle Indian Industrial School, stood firmly in the dewy Pennsylvania grass, bearing the names of children who lost their lives while being forced to assimilate to a new world. Mm. Between 1,500 and 1,800 Native American students from Oklahoma attended the school in Carlisle, Pennsylvania.
So they was taken from their parents in Oklahoma and shipped to Pennsylvania. That's the Bible. It's a true book.
Yep.
They were taken from their parents.
That's right.
You know how far Oklahoma to Pennsylvania? Somebody look it up on their phone or something. How far is it from Oklahoma to Pennsylvania? Go, but you can put an article back up. Pull a barcode back up. Somebody, if you're online, I want you to post it too. Go ahead, read that next. The purpose of?
The purpose of Carlisle, as well as other boarding schools across the nation, was to remove Native Americans from their cultures and lifestyles and assimilate them into the white man's society.
Why? Assimilate them into the white man's society. Now, this is the thing about what they done they did not realize. They admitted it, but they didn't realize what they was really doing. Go to that James Adair history book. What? How far is it now? It's 1,321 miles. How far does it take to get there? How long? Night and that's driving. That's going 80 to 90 to 100 miles an hour when the police ain't around. It's what? 437 hours.
Come on now, dog.
Walking. Because that's how they got there, y'all.
Yeah.
They walked there.
How many days is that? You got to divide that by 24.
437 hours of walking. Now, let's do that. 437 divided.
18 days.
18
that's,
days.
That's 18 days nonstop walking. That's walking for 24 hours a day. So if they stop, eat, sleep.
Come on,
somebody died. Somebody them died. Come on, they got to take the chain off of somebody.
That's a month
of walking. 437 hours.
With sickness. Your feet going to swell up.
That's why that Trail of Tears, man, is that didn't
it's
happen.
It's called
to,
that. Listen to
Trail. Check trail the, that's tears. Why that's called the Trail of Tears, because that type of thing, that didn't happen to nobody else in history. Where you hear about them being forcibly removed from one side of the country to the other and have to walk. They didn't happen to the fake Jews.
Nah.
Being put on ships and have to cross the ocean for 6 months where wasn't no power boat, steamboat. That's why Daniel said the stuff that happened to Israel, you ain't going to find that nowhere else on earth. Nowhere.
Bishop brought out what happened, how the what ships the real, those fake Jews went on.
Oh,
those
yeah.
cruise ships.
That was cruise ships. You're right. Pull up at James Adair history real quick. Adair's history of the American Indians. Go on Amazon and get this book so you can have it in your collection of history. Let's go to the next image. History of the American Indians. This is a white man that lived amongst them, followed them around. Go ahead. Let's see what he says in his table of contents about them. Read that of the contents, the highlighted parts.
Observations on the origin and descent of the Indians.
Of the Indians, uh-huh.
Observations and arguments in proof.
In what?
In proof.
In proof of what?
Of the American Indians being descended from the Jews.
Being descended from who?
From the Jews.
Give me that in Genesis chapter 49.
Did a black Hebrew Israelite write that?
No, that's a white man.
That's a white man?
That's a straight up white man.
Okay.
So he said that.
I'm guessing he's anti-Semitic.
Oh, yeah. You know. Anybody that speaks truth is anti-Semitic. Genesis 49:19. They might have to walk 400 something miles. You might have make movies about them in boarding school where you stripped them from their language, took everything from them,
come
made
on
them
now,
assimilate,
dog.
And then come back 600 years later and say, "Oh, we don't agree that they made y'all Christians and Catholics. We sorry that we did that, and don't give them shit behind it."
My bad.
Yeah, my bad, y'all. We sorry.
My bad.
Genesis 49:19. This is what they didn't realize even with all of that. Go ahead.
Genesis chapter 49 and verse 19.
Uh-huh.
Gad, a troop shall overcome him.
Gad, a troop. Who's that troop? It's the U.S. Cavalry. The troops overcame them. The conquistadors. The troops overcame them. Go ahead.
But he shall overcome at the last.
He's going to overcome in the end. Now, check this out, y'all. This is Four Corner News. We bring out news from all over the earth and out of the Bible and show you it's a true book. The Bible just said, Gad, the Native American Indian that's going to be overcome by that troop, he shall overcome at the last, in the end. Here is the proof that they are beginning to overcome.
Bring it out.
At the end. Play that video from Captain Gad in Denver.
Bring it out. And it shall become an and thou shall become an astonishment, mm-hmm. a proverb, and the byword.
What is a byword?
Look at them. This is Gad sitting in a church. And I'm talking about the people, not Captain Gad. But the people reading about who they are in the Bible. Overcoming at the end.
That's right.
Run it back a few seconds and play it again. Go ahead.
Astonishment, a proverb.
A proverb.
And the byword.
What is a byword? Do you guys know what a byword is?
Byword? Explain.
Mm-hmm. So a byword is being called something as a derogatory term. So it's not your name.
Yeah.
That's a byword.
She understood
so someone's
that.
Someone's mocking you. Mm-hmm. Just like today they call us Native Americans. They call us Indians. They call us, give me some more.
Red, man.
Redskins. Mm-hmm. They call us all these, they call us black. You know, they call us Hispanic. These are property. The same people that enslaved us put these names on us. Because before, you guys were pushed to this little piece of land in Colorado, you wasn't calling yourselves Indian. We wasn't calling ourselves American. We wasn't calling ourselves these names. We wasn't even speaking English. You know? Mm-hmm. So who were we before we were conquered?
Pause.
That's the...
Who was you before you was conquered, Gad?
Mm.
Gad is about to overcome in the end.
Oh,
the Bible's a trooper. Thank you for that late-ass bomb.
That's right. Yeah, it was late.
It was late.
How, Sway?
Gad overcoming in the end. You can keep your damn sorries or whatever, you damn John Paul, whatever his name is. I keep calling him John Paul. Wasn't that a damn reggae singer?
Yeah. Yeah, from Benji. Yeah.
Sean Paul.
That's what
no affiliation.
What
Sean
is.
Paul.
He has no affiliation. Pond the river.
Pond the bunk.
Whatever. Gad is going to overcome in the end, and that's the beginning
right.
stages of it that you see right there.
What is a nation?
Nation is men leading by example. Nation is family. Nation is community. Nation is children with role models.